And to protests here in the U.S., where there was continuing criticism today about the way officials at a public university in California dealt with an Occupy group this weekend. NewsHour correspondent Spencer Michels has our report.
It began on Friday afternoon at the University of California, Davis. Student protesters locked arms on the quad. What happened next would send this web video viral throughout the weekend. Police in riot gear began to pepper spray the dozen or so Occupy Davis demonstrators at close range. Students in the nearby crowd shouted at the officers as the orange mist doused the faces of their peers. Authorities say pepper spray is an inflammatory agent that renders people incapacitated, but only temporarily. University officials reported that after the pepper spraying, 9 students were treated at the scene and 2 were taken to hospitals. 10 were arrested. The video sparked outrage. 2 unnamed officers were placed on administrative leave pending an investigation. And University Chancellor Linda Katehi told listeners today on a call-in show at KQED Public Radio that she disagreed with the way the officers acted.
They were not supposed to use force. It was never called for. What I saw on the video, it has been horrific, and it's not what really represents our campus. As an educator, as a human being, I felt I was filled with outrage.
The origins of the incident began after students set up an encampment on Thursday to rally against tuition increases and support the larger Occupy Wall Street movement. Many students camped overnight against university policy. On Friday, campus police came to forcibly evict the remaining demonstrators. That's when the officers used the pepper spray. Campus police chief Annette Spicuzza was placed on leave by university officials this morning. Yesterday, however, she would not comment on whether the officers acted appropriately.
It's a very fluid, dynamic situation. These are split-seconds decisions. As police in general, we do the best we can. We're here to serve and protect. And I know some people, many people, are very disappointed and or shocked by what they saw. But I think this investigation will help we'll bring this to a closure, we hope. We'll find some closure with this investigation.
The incident also has sparked a number of calls for the chancellor to resign. But over the weekend, Katehi said she saw no reason to do so.
I don't believe that it's appropriate for me to resign at this point. Really, I do not think that I have violated the policies of the institution.
In a move of solidarity, protesters from Occupy Sacramento gathered in Davis today supporting the UC students. Katehi is giving a task force 30 days to issue a report on Friday's controversy. Here in San Francisco, 80 miles southwest of Davis, demonstrators remain in a downtown plaza where they've been for weeks. Over the weekend, police removed 12 tents from in front of the Federal Reserve Building, and they made 6 arrests. In addition, some of the demonstrators blocked Market Street temporarily. And across the bay, occupiers in Oakland rallied at a downtown park on Saturday. That demonstration ended Sunday morning without incident.